It might be unfair to say I'm new to game development, because I'm in my 40s and I've been working on game projects here and there since I was old enough to type on a keyboard, but it certainly feels that way. Most recently, I've been working on a puzzle game called The Secrets of Skellig, where the gameplay is inspired by crosswords. Over the last year, I've been learning Godot, Blender, Substance Painter, and a slew of other game development tools, and I'm happy with the progress towards making my first 3D standalone game. I thought I'd make a video to show my workflow about adding an asset to the game, and a technique I stole from my web development past. This room is the library, and currently has the last puzzle in the tutorial area of the game. I'd never been happy with how it turned out. I thought it would be cool to have shelves built into the wall like this full of books, but it just looks boring to me. I had the idea to replace the angled shelves with a solid wall, then to put a wardrobe in front of it. I found a reference on Google Images that I liked. My first task is to rearrange the mesh for the room in Blender. I made this room some time ago, and I immediately see a bunch of design decisions I hate, so I can't help but correct those as I go along. This also means I have to redo the UVs after, but that won't take too long. Once I've exported it as a GLTF file, it updates in Godot automatically. Now I just have to remove the props I'd put in that are no longer visible behind the new wall. I always like to get started with a big gray box to get the size just right. I'm sure there are talented artists out there who can spend all their time in Blender and just export one asset when they're done, but I find myself having to go back and forth constantly. One principle I've stolen from my web development past is convention over configuration. I learned this when I first started using Ruby on Rails. The idea is, rather than wiring everything up manually, which is tedious and error-prone, you name things very consistently and then have your software wire it up for you. To get what I want, I have to use some scripting, but it speeds things up a lot. Here's the basic idea. My blend files are saved in a subfolder for the level or area. In this case, it's underground. I realize that the UND prefix there is somewhat repetitive since it's already the underground folder, but I started doing it early enough and I have to stick with it now. In Godot, I like to use GLTF files, so I have a folder structure that matches it. If I make a Godot scene from it, or create a script for it, it all follows the same pattern. Now you might be thinking, Evil Trout, I do this. It's called being organized. What's so special? What's special is that if I always stick to this convention, I can have tools use the file names of things to save me a lot of clicks and typing. For example, exporting in Blender the first time a blend file loads is 9 clicks. After that, it remembers some of my choices, and it's about 4. That doesn't seem like much, but it adds up. Instead, I attach a Python script I wrote to each new blend file. After that, saving is as simple as hitting space and enter. The Python script checks where the current file is saved and exports it as a GLTF with my settings right in the appropriate Godot folder. It can also do some more advanced stuff, for example, auto-hide or unhide objects depending on their names, but that's more advanced. Now that I'm happy with the model, I'll add some UV seams and load it into Substance Painter for texturing, again referring to my reference for inspiration. Godot supports PBR, or physicality-based rendering, which means you can have many textures for one asset. Substance Painter is great for generating these. However, it can be quite tedious to import each texture into your Godot material. For my workflow, I have 3 textures for each mesh. The first one is albedo, or color. The second is ORM, which is ambient occlusion, roughness, and metallics, all baked into one texture. The final one is the normal map. I used to have Substance Painter export all 3, then in Godot choose each one from a file picker when setting up the material, but it really started to grind on me. Fortunately, this is another place where we can use convention over configuration. Godot has support for a feature called import post-processing. You can drop a script in your project and easily have it run each time a GLTF is imported. I have a script that looks at the file name and automatically builds a material if the textures are present. For example, my wardrobe textures are named like this. If any of them are missing, it's fine. It'll use what it can find. I also have a system to allow reuse of materials across meshes. If the mesh was exported with a material name, it'll look for that first. For example, if I have many rocks, I can export them all with the same material name, something like UND rock, and it'll find the material and wire it up automatically. Writing the scripts to do this takes a couple hours of time, but over the length of a project, it'll make a huge difference. It honestly feels like a programming superpower once you really get into it. My model is finally coming together, and I think the room looks much more interesting now. I'm sure I'll come back and tweak it in the future, though. If my game looks interesting to you, I'm sure I'll post more videos about it over time, so go ahead and like and subscribe. In the meantime, you can wishlist it on Steam, which is helpful to me as the game's primary developer. Cheers!